Hello. I am Harvey. Today's video is not a gameplay video, but showcasing the teams I used for the first 7 quests. As a free-to-play player, you might have a very limited roster of characters. I am one of you as well. The 7 quests before the actual power and magic's chasm, rising is a lot to ask for without boosted characters that won't get restricted. So, I will first show you the teams that I used here, then I will jump in to show you the gear and mention some key points. First, it is the easiest among the 7 in my opinion. Malady's Chasm, rising feature boss that is weak to debuffs and nothing really strong against. That being said, you can use whatever you want. I recommend you to leave this one first and do it last. I basically used the remaining geared up characters for it. Lael as a friend support is superior by the way. If you are having difficulties with the quest, that might be what you are missing. The second one is Magic and Wind's Chasm, rising. I am glad that I have Fujin on my side, so it isn't really a problem. However, you can use any magic damage dealer to replace her. To me, Edge is the key for this quest. Pull the enemies away from the early waves so your other characters can clear the waves faster. At the final wave, switch it to Lael friend support and start launching with summon. This way, you can prevent the bad breath from happening, which helps a lot. The third one is Ice's Chasm, rising. I believe that this one should be a more challenging one for most of you. The first ice element character that come into my mind is Papalimo. However, the key for the quest is actually Palum. I only have his 35 CP weapon at 0 limit break but it still works extremely well. His task is to clear the first few waves quick and speed up the fight. This quest has a super low turn count requirement, so a turn matters a lot. If you don't have Palum's weapon, you might have to ask for a Palum friend support. A little difficult to find one, but that's the way to go. Vaughn is also a great choice here but I thought the fights later need his presence. So I didn't use him for this fight. The fourth one is the most tricky in my opinion. It is the Earth and Dark's Chasm, rising. Dark element means my beloved Cecil can be good here. Just can, but not great. Still, I used him as a launcher for the final boss and seesaw strategy for the early waves. Seesaw strategy is the strategy that keep bouncing the bravery between Hope and Rim. I also used Lael as my friend support to boost up the score. I called for his help during the third wave and launched the mini boss there. Next up, we have Holy and Ghost's Chasm, rising. You can also make some free choices here as well. I used my Lael here as there is no more fight that require his help anymore. Echo here serves as the bravery battery for the launches and provides buffs to the party. The last member I chose is Vanille. I chose her just because I own her 35 CP weapon. She is generally a good character in my opinion even without her weapons. If you don't want to use her, you can choose to use any magic damage dealer here. It works in the same way. Here comes the most difficult quest for me and me only. It is the Melee's Chasm, rising. If you follow my account closely, you should know that I am lack of melee characters in general. This is the best melee team that I can come up with for my account. Still, most of the melee characters should do just fine here. I think this quest is bugged or something actually. I finished the quest at turn 40, which is the turn limit. However, I still got a score higher than the required score. It's a good thing to players I guess. The next one is Range and Thunder's Chasm, rising. Well, Range and Thunder, Vincent that is. If you don't have his 35 CP weapon though, I think he might not be a good choice. Other characters can just be either ranged physical damage dealer or characters that attack with thunder element. Kind of easy for me as I got Lightning's X weapon and Vincent's 35 CP weapon. But I guess this should not be an difficult quest for you either. The final one is Power and Mannequin's Chasm, rising. I completely ignored the power part and just focus on the mannequin's part. If you played Japanese version of this game, you might found this team composition familiar. Bald here is outstanding for this quest and he can steal the important buffs from the mannequins. Vaughn is actually not good here that I recommend you to replace him with other melee damage dealers. Kateseth here is just a support unit. Well, I saved him for the last I guess. Agrias is the best friend support unit for this quest in my opinion. Well, actually, most of the quests here can become much easier when you got a Agrias friend support. I guess that's about it. Remember that you can always get carried by your friend support as these quest is extremely short. If you really cannot complete one with your team, you may try to build around your friend support unit. I wish you good luck with these 7 quests. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.